Hey friends, welcome to my channel. So before starting this video, I have a pretty cool question for you, and this question is going to check your computer skills, so please listen carefully. I have this file dlinfo.txt in my computer, and what this file is, it's basically a bunch of information about my previous download. So it contained the file name, it contained the download speed in MB per second, also in the end it contained how much minute it took to finish the downloading. So for example, for this file Mr. Robot, this file got downloaded on an average of 5 MB per second of download speed, and it took 56 minutes to finish this downloading. So now what you have to do is, you have to write a program or do something to just tell me how much data I downloaded in my computer in GB. So the answer should be in GB. So I hope that you guys came up with some kind of solution to solve this problem, and what now I'm going to do is I'm going to show you my way of solving this problem. But before this, let me just quickly tell you the logic of solving this problem, which is pretty simple. The first thing you have to do is convert this minutes into seconds, because the speed is in seconds, like MB per seconds, and here's 2040, which is how many seconds it took to download this file, and I can just simply multiply this with the speed, so 12 MB per second, and here I got how many MBs it took to download this file. And now all I have to do is do the same thing for all these files and sum up the results, and this way I will get how many MBs I downloaded in my computer, and in the last I can just divide it by 1024 to convert MB into GB, and I will get the solution which I want. But the real issue is how you are going to implement this. Well, most commonly what people do is they just start writing some kind of program, C program, Python program, which is the most common thing. I asked this question to one of my friends, and he start writing a Emacs macro for this, and he did this that way. So everyone have different way of solving this problem. So now I'm going to show you my way of solving this problem, and I think that you guys will love it, because I'm going to solve this problem by using awk, and you are going to know why awk is must learn programming language. So let me just quickly tell you how awk works. So you write awk and then some kind of operation like print operation, and in the end the file name. Okay, so I write print operation, so it's just going to print the file. And now what I don't want is, I don't want this first line because it's nothing but just a header. So what I can do is, in the awk there is a variable nr which stands for number of rows. So if nr is greater than 1, only I want to do this operation. So yeah, in awk you can just write a condition and then write some kind of operation. So that operation only run when the condition get true. Okay, so if I run this, now I'm not getting the header, so this way I got rid of this first line. So now for awk, this is dollar symbol 1, this is dollar symbol 2, this is dollar symbol 3, okay, which is basically the columns, and these columns are by default get separated by spaces. So what I can do is, I can just print dollar symbol 2, which is basically the download speed, and if I press enter, here I got all my download speed. And I can also just print dollar symbol 3, which is the amount of time it took to finish the download, and if I press enter, here's the time in minutes. And now there's one more thing about awk, you can do math operation by using awk. So I can just multiply these two values. Also I want to multiply this dollar symbol 3 with 60 to just convert it into seconds. Alright, so if I press enter, here I got my result, which is nothing but basically the size of all the files in MB. So since this moment, I just want you to just keep thinking like how it is like to solve this problem by using some kind of other programming language like C, Python, Java, how much work this thing is going to take. And by using awk, all you have to write is just this simple line. But still we haven't reached our goal. So what I want is, I want to know how much data I downloaded in gigabytes. So what I can do is, here instead of printing this, I can just store it into some variable, and I can just continue summing it into this sum variable. So I'm using plus equals to, and if I press enter, it's not going to give me any output right now because I am not printing this sum variable. So I can write one more operation here, print sum, and now if I press enter, it's going to give me the answer, but it's giving the sum variable for all the rows, but all I want is this last value. So yeah, I just want to get rid of all of this. So what I can do is, here I can write this end in awk program, and what this end do is, it basically means whatever operation I write after this, it's only going to get run for the last input stream. Okay, so if I press enter now, I'm just going to get this sum value once. Also, just for your knowledge, you can also write begin here, and what this begin will do, it's just going to run this operation for the first iteration. Now I'm getting my answer in megabyte. So this is basically how much data I downloaded in megabyte. And what I can do now is I can just divide this sum value with 1024, and if I press enter, I'm getting my result in GB. So I downloaded 362 GB, and obviously these were just fake numbers. I never downloaded any of this data. Now one more thing what I can do is I can also write this GB here and press enter. So here I'm also getting a GB in the end. So yeah, I'm getting my result by just writing this one little command. So that's the power of awk. Imagine solving this problem by writing some programming language. One more thing what you can do here is you can just remove this NR is greater than 1, because awk is pretty smart. It ignores when the value is not a number or a string. So if I press enter, I'm still getting what I want. So here this thing got even more shorter. So the purpose of showing you this example was just to convince you guys to start learning awk programming. And this is not something very huge or big. It's not going to take an entire month reading a 1,000 pages long book. You can learn awk in just one day. It's pretty easy. Also, it's very useful, especially nowadays when we have these machine learning things and data analytics kind of work where we have to work with data. People do a lot of work in spreadsheets and these kind of things. You can use awk to do lots of things quickly. And let me suggest you a book which you can read to, you know, learn awk programming. And this is a very popular book. So let me open this in Jathura, the awk programming language. And here's the book. So this is a pretty cool book. Let me show you the front page. The awk programming language, it's a very old book. So I guess this book is like 200 pages long, and I read this. And what I'm planning to do is I'm planning to create a complete awk programming series which contain everything you are going to read in this book. So here you can see the begin end, which I just told you in the video. You can buy this book from Amazon, or if you are not into book, you can watch my video or do anything, but learn awk programming, because this is a must learn thing. You are going to use awk in your life. I'm 100% sure. There are a lot of scenarios where you have to do things, and awk can be very useful. And if you guys are still not convinced to start learning awk programming, I'm going to make a video about how I automated my internship work by using awk programming, and I earned a lot of money by doing nothing thanks to awk. So yeah, it's a highly underrated thing, and I want people to just, you know, start doing this thing. We are